y'all. Welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to show you how to make a spicy navy bean and black eyed pea soup. I made this on New Year's, and no, it has nothing to do with good luck for me. I just made it out of tradition. So I'm adding about a little over a cup of mixed black eyed peas and navy beans to the pot. I'm going to use my instant pot for this recipe, so I will put everything in the description box below. And first, we're going to start off with a can of diced tomatoes. I use organic diced tomatoes. And one other thing I want to add is I did not soak these beans because I decided on this recipe at the last minute. So you could either soak your beans overnight or for 8 hours to make them easier to cook. Next, I'm going to add black refried beans. You can use whatever kind of refried beans you'd like. For this recipe, I chose the black ones because that's what I had in my cabinet. So you can use whatever you want, but just make sure they don't have any animal fat in them. Choose the vegetarian variety for black refried beans or regular refried beans. The reason I like to add refried beans to my recipes is because it makes the soup more, it thickens the soup. It gives it more of a hearty feeling when you're eating it. So if you're looking for a hearty lay on your stomach type of meal, that's what refried beans are going to do for your soup. You can feel free to leave this step out. You could just add regular black beans or whatever kind of beans you want to add to this dish. It's just that's just a tip to make it a little heavier. Y'all know I love garlic. I'm using the kind that is already cut up or minced, and I'm just adding as much as I want. I think like a spoonful, but you can add as much garlic as you want to your dishes. You can use fresh, you can use powder, you can use whatever you want. I love garlic in my soups. Next, we're going to add the bouillon. I use Better Than Bouillon vegetable base. I love it as it has great flavor, so I'm putting one rounded teaspoon in there. Next, I'm going to add some kick. This is crushed red pepper. You can add as much as you want or you can leave it out. Onions make everything taste better, so I'm going to add some onion powder. I put about a teaspoon, half to a teaspoon in it, but you can put as much as you want. There's no rule. I'm going to add parsley. You've got to add some herbs to your soup. Add whatever herbs you like. In this case, I got some parsley and I put about a teaspoon in it. You can even put a tablespoon in it. It's just gonna bring the flavors out. I love adding coriander or cumin to my soups. It gives it like a smoky flavor. So I have added, let's see, about a teaspoon, but you can add more, but you don't wanna put too much because you don't want it to overpower the soup. So start with like a half a teaspoon, you know, taste it, see how you like it. You might want more, and you know, the next time you might want less. So play it by ear. I gotta have onions for my soup. This is about a half of a large yellow onion, Vidalia onion specifically. I just chopped it roughly and added it to the pot. If you don't like onions, you can just leave it out, or if you want to use a different variety, use whatever kind of onion you like to use. So sometimes I like my soup hot, so I add hot sauce. I'm going to put about 8 shakes of hot sauce in here, and it was pretty spicy when it was done, so it was perfect. So if you don't like spicy, leave out the spicy food. You can put other things in it. You could add lime or lemon to give it like a bring the flavors out instead of using hot sauce. You can also use fresh herbs instead of dried herbs. You can do whatever you want. So like I didn't need anything else hot. This is pepper, fresh cracked pepper. You can leave it out or you can put it in. I like it because it just brings out the flavor. Now it's time to add the water. You can add as much water as you want, really. I think I put about 2 cups of water in here. But it just really depends on how liquefied you like your soup. And then all you have to do is stir all the ingredients around. And in this particular case, I used the Instant Pot, in which you do not have to make this recipe in the Instant Pot. You can do the same thing on top of the stove. For
the stove, all you do is you put all the ingredients in the pot, you bring it to a boil, and you let it simmer for like an hour to an hour and a half until your beans are soft. And for the Instant Pot, I'm going to show you what you need to do for this in just a second. So I'm moving the camera here so you can see the front of the Instant Pot. So there is a bean chili setting, or you can use the manual setting and set it for however many minutes you want it to cook. In this particular case, I set it on the bean setting. I hit the button and it was 40 minutes, and I put the lid on top and I let it cook until it was finished. I love the Instant Pot. It is actually how I survived without having a kitchen for the last 5 or 6 weeks. I had no appliances, and this is how I cooked whenever I did decide to cook. So now it's done, and the steam is being let out of the pressure cooker. So if you see that little knob up there, that's where the steam comes out. And now I'm going to take the lid off and show you what it looks like now that it's done. Okay, it's done. The beans are soft. Everything is all melded together. It smells really good. And we got, let's see, 4 servings out of this. So I ate this twice and my husband ate this twice. And it was really hearty servings, and we served it with quinoa. It doesn't look the most appealing because I get probably because it's the black beans, but it really, really tastes really good, y'all. So I hope you try it. Here's what it looks like. It was so good. I even sprinkled a few of the red crushed pepper on top. Thanks so much for watching, you all. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and please share these videos with everybody you know. Take care.